the Lord in this time.
God is drawing the nations to himself.
And whatever it takes for him to draw their attention to him,
he's
going to do it. So don't be scared. You are safe. The Bible says the name of the Lord is strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are what? And they are safe. Are you safe? My sister, are you safe? Are you in the name? Are you in the tower? We are in Daniel 11:32. The Bible says, but in those times, the people that know the Lord, their God, shall be strong. They shall do exploits. What are those exploits? Someone needs to rise up from this church and come up with a medicine for coronavirus. International, a global problem right now.
It's one of you to sleep and dream a dream.
Omukumwa yeta agenda lote chiroto. Ngakatonda amugamba. Nti boga tenkeje. Ensajja. Ngayakala. Ngayakali ya kuluazi. Ngatelugenda ngakomazi. Weta gokulota something. Kengezako bagamba. Ozukuke, ogende ku TV ogambe. Bana Uganda munywe nkeje buli anywa yawona. Bali balwala emisota gyabaluma. Buli yatunulanga kugwe chuma naona mukuva. Sima ya Mungu biri ya bulugani. Are you going to work with God? Those of you that are scared, you can go home. These are times of Exodus. People must come from Egypt back to God.
The nations that don't believe in God were the first to be befallen by this virus.
God is doing something, church.
And sit, let me begin from there, then I'll leave this place. We shall have the announcements. Let me say this, there is no coronavirus in Uganda. According to what the Spirit is saying, that virus is not still in here. The other news is that it won't come in your house. Even if it comes, you sneeze once and go back to your workplace.
I'm saying you are safe under the name of Jesus. Another thing you're
going to hear,
I suspect after this disease has disappeared, the world economy is going to be shaken up. But I'm
telling you the truth.
The Lord shall provide for his own. I say the Lord shall provide for his own. We are not going to stop anything we are doing. We will do everything by the hand of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So therefore, I encourage you, please, do not move with fear. You are under protection. These are the time to put on the whole armor of God. The element of your salvation. Gird yourself with a belt of truth. Put on the shoes of salvation. A sheath in your chest. Be under the protection of the Lord. Hear the voice of the Lord. Amen, church.
Amina.
And God
told me that we should continue doing what we have been doing.
Bible,
the Bible says that will he find them working
doing.
Or doing.
So let's keep doing what we are called to do. Amen.
Amina.
2-3 weeks ago we presented to you our strategic plan as a church from the vision we have. And in the next 5 years, we are going to be pursuing that. It is God who spoke to us. Therefore, all these other fears and everything that's going on around us, for us, we shall hold a weapon in one hand, a building thing in another hand. The work of the Lord must go on. We are not called to fear, but we are called to believe. Someone gave me a verse here, Hebrews 11:1. For the Bible there says, but now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. We will move by faith of the things that we hope for. Do you have hope to build a home? Do you have hope to do something bigger than yourself? Faith. Let it be your substance. We have already seen them in the spirit. And we say it in our strategic plan. In the next 5 years, we are going to win over 5,000 people.
You understand your club, but it's coming in Jesus' name.
We did not. We said over 5,000. And we said that each one of us is supposed to bring how many people here? We said how many? 3 people.
So
can I see those hands that have already started? Can I see the hand that I've already started?
If you've begun evangelism, even though they have not yet come, raise your hands. Do not be ashamed of the gospel. So for you who have not raised your hands, maybe you are not here or you did not hear
starting
us.
Starting this month, you are hunting for 3 people. You are hunting for 3 people. We know Baleta one.
You got to bring them here. Even though you bring them and they go, but let them come here at least. As long as they're written in heaven. Praise the Lord. And we said we are going to continue the building of the cathedral where they will sit up there. You are the only one left among us all. Amen. We're going to build that cathedral where the 5,000 will sit.
We're going to
lay out the parking where they'll park their cars.
On
that building, we are going to have the Sunday school where our children will go.
It's a challenge that God has given us. But let me go to what God impressed on my heart this week. 1 Samuel 22 and verse 1 to 5. 1 Samuel 22:1-5. The Bible says, David therefore departed from there and escaped to the cave of Adram. So when his brothers and all his father's family heard it, they went down there to him.
Daudi cheyavavayo naduka natuka kumpuku ya Adulam. Awo baganda be nabe nyumba ya chitawe yonna bweba chiwulira neba serengeta neba genda jali.
So why did his family leave wherever they were to go?
They
went to him.
They
went to who? To David. The cave was there before David.
But no one
went there before David.
Went.
So the people came to the cave because David was there.
Stay with me. Verse
2.
And
everyone who was in distress, everyone who was in debt, and everyone who was discontented gathered to him. So he became captain over them. And there were about 400 men with him.
Awo buli muntu eyalina enaku, na buli muntu eyalina ebbanja, na buli muntu eyalina obuyinike, ne bakungaana gyali, n'afuuka omukulu waabwe. Awo ne waba naye abasajja nga ebikumi bina.
Then David went from there to Mizpah of Moab, and he said to the king of Moab, please let my father and my mother come here with you till I know what God will do for me.
Awo Dawudi navayo nagenda e Mizupe echa Moabu nagamba kabaka wa Moabu nti chitange ne mange nagamba kabaka wa Moabu nti chitange ne mange bafulume babe namwe okutusa lwendi manya Katonda byali nkolera.
So he brought them before the king of Moab, and they dwelt with him all the time that David was in the stronghold.
Awo ne baleta mu maso ga kabaka owa Moabu ne batula naye ekiseera kyonna Dawudi ng'akyali mu mpuku.
Now the prophet God said to David, do not stay in the stronghold. Depart and go to the land of Judah. So David departed and went into the forest of Heleth.
Awo nabbi God n'agamba Dawudi nti, tobeera mu mpuku, genda otuke mu nsi ya Yuda. Awo Dawudi n'agenda n'atuuka mu kibira Keresi.
Now,
Akano.
This is one of the trainings of David that God had to take him through before he became a king. The story of David starts in 1 Samuel
16.
He's forgotten by his family. But then the prophet sends for him and he came and he was anointed. In chapter 17, in chapter 16, the last verse the Bible says, after the anointing of David, his next assignment was to become a servant, I'm a bearer to King Saul. In chapter 17, David had to kill a giant, Goliath. It is a test of our faith. Especially those of us that are going to reign with Christ. At some point, you must kill the giant, your personal giant. And when you kill your giant, the nation shall be blessed. In chapter
18,
David comes to a big scene where he makes a covenant, or a relational covenant, a relationship covenant with Jonathan.
Dawudi atuka kusa edene wakolera endagane eyonkolagana wakati weneyo na Sani.
Jonathan takes everything that made him a prince next to be king in line.
Yonasani na kwata buli kimwe kyali kimufulanga prince.
Ekyali
kigeno muwo bwakabaka nachi yali mulangira. Ekyali kigeno muwo bwakabaka nabi wa Dawudi.
And he gave them to David.
Nabi wa Dawudi.
Everything that signified and identified him as the next in line for the kingship, he gave it to Jonathan. And when his father Saul found out that Jonathan has donated his leadership to David, the only way that Saul could break that covenant was death.
Engeri yokka Saulo gye yali asobola okutula endagaano eyo oba omukago ogwo kwali kufa.
Are you following me, church?
Mungoberere bulungi kanisa.
Be careful.
Wegendereze.
Covenants.
Omukago.
A lifetime relationship.
Omukago ebera nkolagana ya bulamu
bwonna. You cannot break a covenant.
Tosobola kutula mukago.
Covenants unbreakable.
Emikago tejikutulwa.
Once you make a covenant with someone.
Kafunokola omukago no muntu yena.
Only death.
Okufa kwaka
can separate.
Kwe kusobola okubawukanya.
So understood the secret.
Kakano Saulo yategere chama echo.
And he knew as long as David lived.
Era na manyanti nga Daudi achari mulamu.
Jonathan will never be king.
Jonathan italiwera kabaka.
Why?
Luachi.
He entered into covenant with David.
Kubanga yaingira mukago ne Daudi.
And so you ask, why did he so persecute David to that extent?
Oronewevu santi luachi Saulo yaiganya Daudi okutuka kuseri.
He wanted to get rid of that covenant.
Yali ayagala kujao mukago ogwo.
And so in chapter 22. David is a fugitive now. He's running for his life. He's trying to find a place of refuge. And then he found a cave. And he went there. So the Bible says, when his father's household heard, they went to him. Not to the cave, but to David. You know why? Because the enemy understands. Are you following me, church? The enemy understands. Once you start working and walking with God, if you get to a place where the enemy cannot touch you, he will try to harm those that are close to you. Are you following me? Those of you that are in ministry, those of you that are determined to walk with God, you need to understand, when the enemy cannot get rid of you, he will attack your family. He will try your children. He will try your parents. That's why every morning I pray the blood of Jesus over my wife, over my children, over my parents, over my brothers and sisters, over this church. I mention names. Why? Because I know I am in a place where the enemy can only look on me and try to stop me. But he knows where to hurt me. But I shed everything that I own with the blood of Jesus. So this week, on Thursday morning, we are doing a pastor's conference in Masaka. And I got a call from Pastor Magoro. And he said, Mercy was attacked by a robber last night. A guy knocked her out, stole her phone and her bag. And I'm wondering, how could that happen? And all of a sudden I realized, Omagolo is in a small community in
Ruelo.
He's telling me every week, he has found a tortoise. Bigger that speaker. He killed that thing in the middle of the night. And as soon as I'd killed it, a man came running. And he was saying, why have you killed him? Why have you killed him? Why have you killed him? Hey. We are not wrestling with blood and flesh. We are after principalities, powers of darkness, rulers in spiritual places. And when you attack them, they shall try to retaliate by attacking whatever you own. Are you listening to me, intercessors? Are you listening to me, preachers? And all of you ministers. This is not just drama. It is not comedy church. It is a real life thing. But we are on the winning side. So you need your family to come to you. I said you need your father to come to you. You need your mother to come to you. You need your children to come to you. Why? Because you are in Christ.
Kubanga oli mu Kristo.
Era musabire nyo family zamwe.
pray a lot for your families.
Mukama favors.
Amina.
Naba mwanyina fe mama Martha yafirwa tatawe 2 weeks ago.
I see my sister mama Martha lost her dad 2 weeks ago.
Yakomio.
She came back.
Ekanisa yagenda nezika.
The church went
to
burial. But let me tell you.
Oyo yomu kubachala basulana nga banonya mukama.
She is one of the ladies that spend nights here seeking the Lord. Abamu temumanyirwa
ache kanisa eneri wano lero.
Some of you don't know why the church is here today.
Wakati mu masabo.
In the midst of the shrines.
Wakati mu basamize ne banabbi
abamu limba. In the midst of preachers and false prophets.
We have people on the front line.
Tuina abantu abatukulembera.
You don't know their names.
Temanyi manya gawe.
You can't see their face.
Temusobala na kulaba bwenyu
bwawe. But the Lord has anointed them.
Ayemu kama abaiye kama.
In the cave, in
Adulam,
and very soon you shall see their people coming to them. And so when David went to Adulam,
kati Daudi bwagenda Adulam,
he did not plan to have people over.
Yete yateka kubena
he was just a fugitive.
Yari aduka.
But the Bible says,
ne Bible yegamba.
Everyone was in distress. Everyone that was persecuted. Those who could not pay their debts. Their rent, their loans, everything.
Renti, mabancha, ziloni,
the discontented ones. They came to him and he became their captain. Now the word captain there is not someone who serves food on the table. Captain is a military title. So you don't become a captain by serving food. That's a military language. If you are ever going to be a captain,
Bobango genabera captain,
you must have a football team.
Or
you must be in the military.
Obo inokuvera maje.
In this case,
katimuchifwe chino.
This is the military language.
Luno lulimi lwa
maje. How do you become a captain?
Ofukotia captain. Obo
the people under you.
Abantu abali wansi.
Are you looking at me, church?
Muntunuli rekanisa.
The people under you.
Abantu abali wansi.
For you to be a captain.
Bokuvera captain.
They must qualify to be well-trained, equipped soldiers.
Baino kubanga batendekebwa bulunje era nga baina buli kimu mu maje.
Okuba abajasi.
To be military soldiers.
Tebasobola kuita captain.
They can't call you captain.
Ngabantu bobo na.
And all your people.
Tasobola dokulasa kasali.
They can't even shoot an arrow.
In the military.
Mu maje.
A captain.
Captain.
Leads a certain number of troops.
Abaka abantu amaje gakulembera abantu banje.
And those troops. They have been trained. And they have weapons to make
them
a captain. So, how did David become a
captain?
He took these people into drills and training and exercises that made them real soldiers. Who were they before they came? People were stressed, under depression, persecuted. Abandoned and forgotten by their families. Useless people in society. They came to David. And what did David do?
Daudi
he could have sent them away. By the time someone comes to you without paying their rent, you know those people can't help you. But you see David, he says in Psalms 18, it is the Lord who trains my hands for war. Somehow he had learned from the Lord and became a captain. And so he was able to pass on his knowledge to his troops. Ladies and gentlemen, the next time you read about the David kind of leadership is in Matthew 10, Mark 6, 7. And I think Luke 9. The Bible says, and then he chose the 12 to come to himself. Out of the 70, he chose the 12 to come to himself. This is what Jesus said. Come, and I'll make you. He did not, some of you read, that come and follow me. But when he chose the 12, he did not say follow me. He told that to Peter and Nathaniel when they came at his house. When he chose the
12,
he said,
"Come,
and I'll make you." Hey, who is not following me? You are
sitting here.
The Lord has never given up on the business of making people. Whatever he purpose, he will make you. Whatever he takes, he shall make you. If he has to dismember you and dismantle you and put you in pieces and model you again and shape you again, you shall not resist. For the Bible says, how can the clay say to the potter, "What are you doing?" For the clay has no power even to speak to the potter. For the potter has the power to break the pot and make it clay again and make a cup out of it. For he is the Lord our maker. Let me tell you something. The Lord shall never use that he has not made. Let me repeat so that you hear me well. The Lord shall never use that which he has not made. He shall break you. He shall dismantle you. He shall dismantle
you.
And after
they get a stick and they beat this clay. They beat the clay and they make a vessel out of it. If they find anything in it, they take it back.
Hey, he says,
agamba,
like silver and gold in the furnace's fire, I shall refine you. The next thing that is about to happen next to the coronavirus, it is called the purification of the church. The Lord shall put the church in fire. Persecution is about to come. There is about to be a tribulation of those who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. He will separate the sheep from the goat. I'm speaking under the anointing. The next thing that is about to happen world over is called the purification of the church. We are many. We are about to become few. But the few of us shall remain. Oh my God. We shall be like a pot that has come out of the furnace of the potter's fire. We shall be like silver and gold that has been purified. Your thoughts about to be checked. Your actions about to be checked. The Lord shall visit each one of us. For those of you that are going to be used, and I know many of you, you will not endure the fire. But it's my responsibility to pass on the information. Matthew 24. And because of lawlessness, the love of many shall grow cold. The church is about to be emptied. I talked to my friends back in Seattle. Pastor Gordon told me, we cannot have services. We are going to try to have a live stream service. And all the other pastors in Washington,
Washington.
No churches this morning. It is now the faith that you've been living on and must stand for you. I'm telling you, one of these days there will be no church in this place. Everyone in their home. I don't know what will cause that, but there will be times we shall hear people in their homes that they gathered 20 people. They brought 20. Another one brought 100. And the lame walked in their living room. Why? Because now is the time for preparation.
God is going to use people.
So these people came to David in distress, in debt, discontented. And what does David become? One of them? No. He became a captain. Not a class monitor. Not a LOC. Not a chief complainer. Not a spokesperson. A captain. A captain is a person who says, you have no one to help you. We must fight for ourselves. We will fight for our children. We will fight for our families. We will fight for our marriages. We will fight for everything. If we don't, no one will. And so David, from that moment, the 400 men, they started raiding villages for food. They indirectly fought the enemies of God in that time. What was David doing? He was preparing them to become a national army. These people in distress. Hey, I was remembering this morning. 20 some years ago, we went to Masulita. Among the people that came, there was this young lady, about 15. She was always the first at every service. Her eyes were looking this way. But she could see you. You think she's looking this way. But she could see you here. Every Sunday she was the first. For 5 years, she was a faithful member. Our first treasurer was a lame woman with a stick. She walked like this. Our first treasurer. And the rest of the members were children. We had another young man. He could come and attentively look at you. And the question you could ask after is what told you that his wires were off? He could not remember where he was. He was on medicine from Butabika. He never understood a thing. We had a few of those. The members we had on the ground did not match with the anointing we had brought.
Hey.
The situation on the ground did not even resemble the dreams we had before we went. But we continue to preach. One day in prayer, we have about 30 kids. They are all unruly. And I'm asking God, what is happening? Why did you even bring us here? Where are the people we saw? Where are the money? And God said, look at those children. Give them 5 years. Those who are 10, they shall be 15. Those who are 15, they shall be
20.
I think this Jennifer was among those, I think she was about 14 or 13. Let me tell you something. Many years went by. And that small Sunday school grew into a mighty army. So, we are doing this strategic planning. We are looking for solutions. We are looking for things we can do as a church. How do we grow Kawempe Worship Center? One of the ideas that came, we need to beautify this
Chidala
so we can attract people who are above us. And that's a brilliant idea. And we shall continue to do that. And we shall try our best. But let me take you back to the old way of making disciples. You look for the cross-eyed, the lame and the distressed, the discontented, those have no school fees, those who can only afford 1 meal in 2 days. You tell them about Jesus. You bring them to church. You teach them the ways of the Lord. You disciple them. You disciple
discipline them.
No, but take them in pizza.
And I'm telling you, after some times,
there
will be the middle class you are looking
for.
Whoever dreamt that Peter, he denied Jesus three times, speaks without thinking, could become a mighty apostle. Preach to 3,000 people and get born again. Let me tell you, church, the 5,000 people will not come from parliament, but they shall go from here to parliament. The 5,000 people, they shall come from nowhere. They are destitute now. They are discontented. They are in stress and depression. But they shall come here. We shall teach them the ways of the Lord. We shall teach them the fear of the Lord. And we shall lay hands on them. And they shall be born again. And they shall be filled with the Spirit of God. And they shall go on. Let me tell you something. The best joy you can ever have in a heart
is
to watch someone who came as nothing and became something. I say that again. The biggest joy you can ever dream of is to help someone who came as nothing but found their destiny and found their dream and now live their dream. What a joy. I found out some time back, the people that you fish from other churches, if they can leave that church, they also leave this one. And I will tell you, the people that you did not personally lead to the Lord, you have no reward in them. Whoever led them to the Lord took your crown. And whoever turns many to righteousness shall shine like a star, a planet. Hey! So I'm telling you, church, fishing from another congregation is a good idea, but doesn't pay much. Because when they come here, they will start comparing. God has never called us to compare. Let people stay where they are. Go to the lake. Fish the fish.
Even if you don't say amen, because many of you it is easier to go in those churches and you begin
bragging.
We have two keyboards, we have a shouting pastor. No, things don't work.
If you are to preach Jesus, tell them about Jesus. Tell them about the repentance of
God
and the forgiveness of sin. If they believe, lead them in a prayer of repentance. If you do, write their name, because that's a crown for you. Those who come after they are born again, someone has already taken their crown.
I'm speaking the truth in Christ and you're pretending that you're not hearing. You're hearing me. You hear me very well. Go to the swamp areas and fish. Bring those that are not yet born again. Open your doors. Open your door. Those that are not born again are not far from you. Go and bring those people near you. Begin giving them food. Give them supper before their mother comes back from a window. Even though you have not yet completed school fees. Get someone with 50,000 and pay. Tell them on Sunday we are going together in church. Preach the gospel.
In season and out of season. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Omuntu.
A person. If you are to begat them,
I'm talking to you. If you are
to give birth to anyone,
you must share your life with them. Ministry is sharing your life with others. So Jesus said, and I will make you fishers of men. He spent 3 years. He poured himself into the apostles. He poured himself into the apostles. When you become what Jesus meant for you, then you draw from that which you have become and serve the people. Ministry is not just speaking. Ministry is not just singing. Ministry is sharing your life. Mumpulira.
I know you're hearing me.
Ministry
Obuereza
is sharing your life. You take from that which you have become and you pour part of your life into another person. But many
of you here,
it is you and yourself. It is me, I, and myself. Your money, your resources, everything you have is about you. But in the days that are coming, the Lord shall give you resources for you to reach out to your neighbors. Sente zogendo kola.
The money you're going to make. Get people that will partake of that money, but not for naught. Bring them to God. Change them. Many of you have spent a long time in church, and now you know the Lord. So get more 3 people. Get more 2 people.
Disciple them. Be a mother to them. Be a spiritual father. Bring them closer. Share your clothing with them. Share your food with them. Meet some financial needs. And them with our spiritual sons.
And you spiritual sons.
I've
not told you to become beggars.
It is from your father's heart that they give. Mukama yebazibwe.
Amina.
Toja kula.
You will not grow
okujako nga nawo inagwo kuza
unless you are growing someone.
Echo kanchi kudiremu.
Let me repeat myself.
Toja kula.
You will never grow
okujako ngo inagwo kuza
until you grow someone.
Njagala kumaliriza.
I'm winding up.
Ne Samueli echo kubiri.
2 Samuel.
Esula 2 musatu.
23.
Olunyirirwa 8.
Verse 8.
Awone bwentula.
Then I will sit down.
Samuel echo kubiri.
Samuel
23.
2 Samuel 2 musatu.
Verse 8.
Nonyiriro lwamunana.
The Bible says.
Bible yegamba.
These are the names of the mighty men whom David had.
Gano kemanya gaba sajja bamanyi Daudi beyalina.
The other version says.
These are
the mighty men of David.
Where
did David get them?
In
1 Samuel
22.
Verse 2. Men in distress. Debts. And discontented. He became their captain. And what did David make of them? Mighty men. These are the names of the mighty men whom David had. The Takemonite. The chief among the captains. Now David is no longer the captain.
Kati Daudi tachari mukuru.
Look at me, church.
Puliriza kanisa ntunulira.
This guy Josheb.
Oh no, Yose.
He's a captain.
Ye mukuru kakano.
So what has David become?
Daudi afusa echi.
A higher rank.
Yate wa aliwa guru.
This is how the kingdom works.
Buno bakabaka bukola.
When you pull someone,
bobako gosika.
They push you up.
Bakusindika wa guru.
This is how the kingdom works. When you pull someone up, they push you up. The more you pull them, the higher you go. This is how the kingdom works. When you pull down someone, they also pull you down.
Never ask yourself, how did I come to this level? I was up. In the church, I was mighty. But now people don't see me around here. So you look at yourself, how many people do you see around?
Whoever you pull up, they shall push you up. Whoever you pull down, they have more energy to pull you down. Physics says, the object on the ground has more energy than the one in the air.
The
verse
says,
chief among the captains, he was called Adino the Asnite.
Adino Mwezeni.
Because he had killed 800 men at one time. This man, Adino, the Asnite, his other name, Josheb, at one time, single-handedly, he fought with 800 men. How did he learn?
From his captain.
He had a disciple maker. Pastor, we were with Pastor Stephen.
Twaine Musumba Stephen.
Pastor Stephen Atria.
Musumba Stephen Atria.
In Masaka this week.
Erie Masaka mwikeno.
He brought me a book. And he said, Pastor, you need this book. From what I see on your life, you need this book. And the title of the book says, Healer Maker. I didn't know I am called to be a healer maker. You see, every one of us wants to be a healer.
But there
is another level. A healer maker. A healer maker. So I picked up the book. And I'm reading it. And I see myself. And I see the principles of Jesus. And I see David. Poor people are poor because they fail to make heroes. People who have nothing are people who decided to be lone rangers. People who have enough have created a circle around them. If you want to be a captain, make soldiers. If you want to be a champion of losers, surround yourself with people who grumble and complain. And I can tell you one thing. All of you cannot find a budget. You don't have food.
You begin sharing underwears and shoes. You are going to begin borrowing those weaves. Because all of you, there is none that pushes the other up. You are all pulling yourselves down. One borrows the other 500. Another one borrows 250. Another one borrows 1,000. And you eat 10 people.
You don't have a circle. We need to make circles
or
provision.
You need 10 million.
If
I have a
circle,
one gives me 5, another gives me 3,
and
I give them back on Monday. But some people here, you cannot even buy one chapati.
Mugeya, muino lugambo.
You are backbiting, you are rumor mongers.
Ne sente zibatia.
Even money fears you.
Ne chapati zibagala.
Even chapatis don't want you.
Enyama yabaduka.
Meat ran away from you.
Ebalengerereri ne yekweka.
He looks at you from afar and hides.
Egamba bobaja kungeya.
He says those ones will backbite me.
Buli kirungi chabekweka.
Every good thing hid from you.
Change your circle. Be a hero maker. Stop complaining. Build a circle of heroes.
Let me read on.
Ono mutabani, ono Adino.
This one, Adino. Single-handedly killed 800.
And after him, verse 9.
Romwenda.
Was Eliezer the son of Dodo.
Eliezer, namudirira mutabani wa Dodai.
The Hohaiti of the three mighty men with David. When they defied the Philistine who gathered there for battle, and the men of Israel had retreated. He rose, attacked the Philistine until his hand was weary and his hand stuck to the sword. The Lord brought a great victory that day, and the people returned after him only to plunder.
Abantu nebadayo enyuma we okunyaga obunyazi.
Eliezer yani?
Who is Eliezer?
Eliezer. Ali wali mu 1 Samuel 22.
He's in 1 Samuel 22.
He was in distress.
Yari mu banja.
He was in debt.
Yari mu banja.
And discontented.
Eranga lekedwao.
David made him a soldier.
Daudi na mfulo
omujas. He did not just be a soldier to follow.
He became
the second in command.
Nafuka mudirira.
Nti one day when they are fighting a battle,
that omulundi gumwe bali balwana,
the rest of the troops retreated. Eliezer stayed on the ground and killed the enemy. And his hand could not move. And his finger could not let the sword go. You can imagine when you are surrounded by enemies. And then you are by yourself. And then you start swinging your sword. Swing your sword. And you kill all the enemy. We need men in our time that have got a grasp of God's word that can wipe the enemy out. People that shall fight witchcraft, single-handedly fight corruption. They are here in the church. Even
if you don't clap, God is going to raise men
that
are filled with the Spirit. They will get the sword of the word, and they'll swing it
Mama fina galewo.
Back and forth. They'll swing it,
and chira
will be on fire, and he will swing it again. And those are
corruption.
You just speak a word. God is going to raise such in our time. We're
going
to see them. But even though they swung the swords, they did not go to start their own kingdom.
These are David's men. The exploits they did, they could have easily walked off to start another ministry
there.
What did David do? He killed Goliath.
Yata Goliath.
What else did he do?
Chicheche la cheyakola.
David never killed the 800.
Daudi tayata lunana.
David never killed all the Philistines.
Daudi tayata wa Filisuti
bana. But you see the kingdom of God.
Na yobwa kabaka bwa Katonda.
It says.
Bukala webuti.
The thing that you see me do.
Je bintu byenkola.
You shall also do.
Muna abikola namu.
And double.
No kusinga wo.
That doesn't make you a savior.
Echo techikufula mulokozi.
Submission is going to be key.
Obweto waze chigena kwera chikuru.
For the advance of the kingdom.
Oruoku musibo bwa kabaka.
Just because you make the lame walk.
Oruoku wacho tambusa
ale. And the dead live.
No
does not mean.
Techitegeza.
That go and set your own kingdom.
Jorogendo okoro bwa kabaka.
These are David's men.
Bano basajja ba Daudi.
Olunyiro oluddako.
The next verse. Verse 11.
And after him was Shammah, the son of Agi the Halalite. The Philistines had gathered together in two troops, where there was a piece of ground full of lintels. So the people fled from the Philistine. Olekuminolum.
Nesama mutabani wa Age omukalari yeyamudirida awaba Filisuti bari bakunganye. Okuwe chibina awali omusiri ogwebi janjaro. Abantu nebaduka abafirisuti.
But he stationed himself in the middle of the field, defended it and killed the Philistine. So the Lord brought about a great victory.
Ntinaye ye naimira wakati mumusiri na kukuma nata abafirisuti. Mukama naleta okuangulo kunene.
How many men are doing this?
Basaja mamekaba kwa chino.
Three.
Basatu.
Shobebu.
Eliezer.
And Shammah.
Neshama.
Hey. This one.
Oh no.
Defended a strategic piece of land.
Yeya kuma aichitundu echetaka.
He stood there.
Na imini
la. And by himself.
Nga imini
he defended it.
Oku na chiruani la.
We need people like that. May the Lord lift up people that will defend the doctrine. May the Lord lift up people that are able to define prophecies. May the Lord lift up people that are able to teach the church how to fight effectively. I pray that out of this church that the Lord shall raise up strategic thinkers. Innovators that shall bring about solutions to nations. So verse 13. Then the three of the 30 chief men went down at harvest time and came to David at the cave of Adram. And the troops of Philistines encamped in the valley of Rephaim.
Tinaba satu kubakuru amakumi asatu. Neba serengeta neba jia eri Daudi mubirebi ya makungula eri mpuku Adulamu. Nechivina chaba Filisuti abari basiside mchiwomfu Lefaim.
David was then in the stronghold and the garrison of the Philistine was then in Bethlehem.
Era Daudi yari mpuku mubirebio naba Filisuti abamuchigo abari mbeserekem.
And David said with longing, oh, that someone who give me a drink of the water from the well of Bethlehem, which is by the gate.
Awo Daudi ne yegomba nayo garanti singa wabaddewo ananyesa amazi agava mu luzzi olwe Beserekemu oluli kuwankachi.
So the three men broke through the camp of the Philistine, drew water from the well of Bethlehem, and was by the gate, and took it and brought it to David. Nevertheless, he could not drink it, but poured out to the Lord, and he said, fight be from me, O Lord, that I should do this. Is this not the blood of men who went in jeopardy of their lives? Therefore, he would not drink this, would not drink it. These things were done by the three mighty men.
Nebawaguza muje eriaba Filisuti nebasena amazi muluzi olwebeserekemu olwali kuwankachi nebagatwala nebagaletera Daudi naye natakiriza kuganywako naye nagafukeri mukama nayogera nti chidireri ayi mukama nzo kukola chino nywe omusayi gwabantu abagenze nobulamu bwabwe Chemfa cheyafagana okunywako ebyo abasajja abasatu abamanyi byebakola.
I believe
inzikiriza
one of the things that is about to happen in the church
is
order.
Order.
You are going to see the church in order. There will be ranks. People respecting one another. But what amazes you about this man? David made them who they are.
Daudi ya wafula chebali.
And they did more than he did.
Nebakola ebisinga kuyebya yakola.
But when the time of need came,
nyakasera kobweta vwekajja.
And their leader had a need.
Erango mukulembeze wabwa inaye chetago.
He needed to drink.
Ngayetago kunywa.
He said, "Oh!"
Nagamant,
"Then I will drink from that the water from that well at Bethlehem."
Singa wabadde wasola kundeta kumansaga bakuluso lye Bethlehem.
And these men had from their tents.
Abasajja banone bawulira chebali.
His need became their opportunity. And they risked their lives. And they said, how can the king have a need in his house, on his life, in his family? They broke through the camp of the enemy. Some of you don't understand. But in war times, what they call garrisons, where military camps, if you are here, the enemy will surround you and leave you no route of escape. So, and then the three had to break through from that line and walk about 25 miles to go and bring water in a jar for their leader to drink. Oh, I pray in Jesus' name that the Lord shall bring back an anointing on the church. That leadership will be in order. That people shall recognize their leaders and the anointing on them. And the Lord shall cause those people to heed their leaders' needs and meet them according to God's standard. These men went. That was the risk of their lives. And the journey was long. But they came back. And then they had to break through the garrisons again. Risk your life twice for the need of a leader. I don't know what happened to our generation. But then may the Lord have mercy on us. I looked yesterday at President Trump's tweet on Twitter and said, tomorrow is a day of prayer. And I saw people responding with rage, disrespecting a leader, dishonoring a leader. I stopped listening to TVs and radios in Uganda. I may not agree with everything this government is doing, but I will swear to myself, I will never be part of their problem. I will never be a part of Uganda's problem. I will always do my national duty. You never hear me on the radio complaining about the government, because I understand I am also a leader in a lower ranks, but higher in the kingdom. I understand leadership. When you lead lead people who do not believe in you. They suck even the smallest of the energy that stays in you. Leaders are empowered by the people they lead. If the people you lead do not trust you, it doesn't matter how many hours you work, you'll be a failure. I pray in this church that the spirit of the three wise mighty men shall fall upon us. We shall see it in the choir, in the men's department, in the women's department, in every rank of this ministry, that there will be honor in our leadership. I'm not asking that you kneel down to me. Honor and kneeling are two different things. Sometimes all we need from you is a little appreciation that we believe in what you are doing. You don't have to give anything. We just need some support. I never forget one time. It is the end of the year. And the enemy attacks leaders with discouragement. And sometimes you stand and you ask yourself, I wonder if I'm helping these people. I wonder if I'm doing anything good. And you go back to your house. And the enemy speaks to you. He says, I know you are wasting your time. If you are doing a good job, those seats will not be empty. If you are doing a good job, everyone who should be standing in worship, end of the year, I got this small letter from a small woman. She doesn't know how to write very well, but I kept her letter. I have it somewhere in my house. She says, Pastor, I just want you to know, if you don't come for anything in Masulita, you came for me. And the Lord brought you just in time. I can't tell you how much you helped my life. And I want you to know, your work is not in vain. But you see, I'm getting this piece of paper in the midst of protests from other leaders, from people who do not appreciate. You preach your heart out. You pray for 7 days. And yet someone will stand up and say, you shot over time. And someone will say, what kind of song is that? Yet you spent nights and hours writing a song. And you have this faith. It is God who gave you. Let me tell you something. I'm telling you this because all of you here are leaders. And you be leaders. You may not be a leader now, but you are going to lead. No one coming to this church is going to just be a pew warmer. No, Neda. You are going to be a leader in the nations or even in this nation. God told me before I came into this place that all my children shall be leaders. So me, I'm convinced. You may be cross-eyed. You may be lame. You may be unknown. You may be a loser. In distress. In debt. Discontented. But since you have come to Adram, by the time you leave this cave, the Lord shall have made you. You will turn into a useful man. God shall add value to you. You shall become something in your family. This nation shall look for you. But let me give you my peace of mind. You need right now to sow a seed of honor. Honor your leaders. I'm not talking about the pastors only. Honor your leaders where you work. Honor your leaders. Me, I give you permission to call me whatever. But honor your leaders. I don't mind when you evil talk about me. I don't mind when you put me down. Me, I am not down. Me, I am already up. I'm seated with Christ in higher places. So no one can pull me down. But I'm telling you, people, there are some people who depend on your opinion, who depend on your support. Work with God and support them. Don't pull our leaders down. These three men, they risked their lives and brought water to their leader. And I'm telling you, David was not perfect. No one of us is perfect. But if you are going to build a kingdom, you need to realize we need to be together. Push the leaders up and they shall pull you out. David's kingdom lasted 40 years. The only division that came did not come from the 400. It came from his house. And guess who killed Absalom?
Absalom.
Joab.
Joab,
one of the mighty men.
Hey,
he said,
Yagamba,
me, I have seen the king in the bush.
Zendabye,
I will not even let his son put my king down. That's a determination I have in the Lord. I'm going to build this kingdom. I don't care who tears me down. I don't care who fights me. I'm determined. Nothing shall separate me from the love of God. Should death or sickness, coronavirus or corruption, accidents or poverty, I am telling you all those things. I am more than a conqueror. And I will not let my faith down. I will stand in the rain. Come rain, come shine. I will serve the king. I am not dependent on what people say or world conditions. I will serve the Lord. I am determined to make disciples. I'm going to be a hero maker. Stand on your feet and start praying for yourself. Please pray that the Lord shall make you, and when he makes you, you shall be a hero maker. I
want to hear you pray.
Pray
no matter how short your prayer is. But say, God, I want my life to touch someone. I
want to change someone. I want to help someone
out.
I don't hear you, brethren. I don't hear you, brethren.
Hero makers don't keep quiet. I want to hear some voices.
Raise your voice and pray. You've heard the message.
That
those who are in troubles, those who are in debt, in the days of David, those with debts were
used to be. And if anyone had money,
you'd go and serve him and serve all his children.
But
the Lord wants you to have eyes that see such people who have been caught up by the world. The lights have caught them. And they have things that are troubling them. May God open our eyes to see those people. May you open our ears to hear them. Because many of them around us, King of Kings, may you turn us into a light. Just as those people saw David, that in him was a refuge. King of Kings, may you turn us into a refuge that we can speak. May you clear
Longoosa ennimi zaffe, tubeerenga n'ebigambo ebinyuma eri amatu g'abantu bano, ebigambo by'okubazza engulu, ebigambo by'okubatendeka okutya n'okuweereza, baleete Mukama mu makubo
gaffe,
kula amaaso gaffe tulabenga we bali okubasemberera, n'amatu gaffe tuwulire we bali, n'ebintu ebibanyiga tuyinza obbakwata ku mikono.
Support them. May you bless our feet.
Bible,
the Bible speaks of them. That blessed are the feet that bring the good news. King of kings. May you bless our feet. That we may follow those ways.
Which
will
show
people that want the good news. That we can get to them always. And to touch them. And to help them. And to bring them close. That they can become a mighty army. That is mighty before you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.